Currently filming this while my room is in a complete mess, but that's only because I've had a really, really productive day so far and the sun is about to set, so I need to film this intro super quick. So hi you guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. This video has been, ever since my channel started, every single video probably had a comment asking me to do a room tour. So it's been what, 4 years now almost, I think? 4 years, and this has got to be the most requested video on my channel ever. So I'm sorry that it took so long, but it's just that the previous house that I was living in was pretty much a mess 24/7. There was no organization in my life, in my house, in just about anything. I'm kind of living in that space, just wasn't making me feel as productive and happy, but I am so happy here and this room has just changed everything for me. So welcome to my dream bedroom tour. It literally, it's like a pinch me moment for me. I can't believe that I'm actually saying this, because I always thought that yeah, my room tour will happen someday, and I can't believe, I can't believe that that day is finally here. Oh my god, I don't want to get carried away and I don't want to make this intro too long. I want you guys to enjoy the video, because the actual room tour is also quite a long video. So a quick couple of really important things that I want to talk about before we get into the room tour. So to answer a lot of your questions that have been coming on Instagram and over here, I live in Mumbai in Lokhandwala. I moved, I've always lived here, like ever since I was like 1 year old. I moved to this building with my mom, with my Masi, with my two dogs, and we live in this house. This is not a house tour, this is just my bedroom tour, because the rest of the house is not ready yet. But my closet is almost ready, so that will probably be the next video, maybe another few weeks, I guess. So that's coming soon, and you guys have been seeing sneak peeks of the house, of the rooms, on the Snob Homes Instagram, and I know that y'all have been waiting for this for so long. So have I, trust me. So basically, this room is something that I have wanted for as long as I can remember. In my previous house, I've never had a dressing table, I've never had a bedside table. I had a desk that I had like ordered off of Pepperfry, and it used to be just kept in a corner with so many other things around it. Like, everything was such a mess. So I'm just really excited to be finally having this kind of space here. Everything in this room, there's so much thought that's gone into every single thing. Like the aesthetic, I wanted a pink, gray, white, light wood and gold aesthetic. So you will see that happening all over the room, and it's not been easy to like find all the different elements that are all over. I've picked up pieces when I've been traveling over the last 2 years. You're gonna find a lot of stuff over here that I have bought on trips, like I mentioned. So like a lot of it is from Primark, actually, because Primark is really affordable and they have the cutest homeware. So I'm gonna try and find alternatives for everything. I've literally spent an entire day trying to look for links to give you guys for all the products, so that you have options. If it's not available in India, you have options to buy. Just know that this is not me showing off in any way. You guys have not stopped asking for a room tour. I love every little bit of this room, and a lot of hard work has gone into putting this together, into making this happen. So please don't take me wrong, and I think my disclaimers are done. So let's get on with it. Welcome to my room. We have Oreo with us, just to bring you guys in, not for the entire tour because she'll get really bored. But this is my bedroom, and I'm so excited that the room tour is finally happening. So starting with this corner, we'll go clockwise, in a clockwise direction around the entire room, and I'm going to start with this. This was basically one of the last furniture items that arrived in the room, and I was literally just waiting for this before I could film the room tour. This is the first time I've ever had a proper dresser in my entire life, and it makes me so excited because firstly, I got this on a really good deal on Pepperfry. Not getting paid to tell you this, I paid for it myself. But it was, I think they had like a sale ongoing that was just for that day, and my carpenter quoted, I think, double the price of what it cost me on Pepperfry, which was a really, really good deal, and it went so well with my room. So basically, I'll insert a picture here of what the dresser looked like originally, and then I just added
the light that you see over here. So we called our electrician and he added like an LED panel so that it's just easier for me to do my makeup and I have really good lighting while I'm doing it, since otherwise I would be trying to do it while I'm facing, while basically in sunlight. Anyway, coming to everything else around the dresser. So I went and bought this planter yesterday. It's from Westside and I wanted it to add to the gold detail of the room, since most of the hardware in my room is gold. So I saw this as another planter on that side of the room that's also from Westside and which is also gold. So these are four plants and I only have four plants around the room because I told you guys that I have allergies recently and I'm basically not allowed to keep real plants in my room, which is really unfortunate. But I love plants, so you'll find quite a few around the room. Coming to what's on here, I basically have this planter that I picked up from Primark easily like 6 months ago. I knew that I wanted the color scheme of my room to be gray and pink, which is why I got this, and it has gold hardware. I have my Starbucks cup with water over here. And these are a few products that I use before I do my makeup. Like, this is what I've been using on my skin recently. Over here, I have a few perfumes. I have this cute little beauty blender stand that I got on SheIn. It was super affordable and it's really nice because otherwise my blender would end up staining the entire furniture and everything around it. So it's nice to have that. And I have this, this is also a planter, this gold thing right here, in which I keep my brushes. I bought this from IKEA. I think it's been like 3 or 4 years. I bought silver and gold ones. My mom uses the silver ones in the rest of the house, but I kept the gold one for my brushes. Then over there, I just have palettes that I've been using recently and stuff that, all the stuff actually in all of these drawers on top is stuff that I use on a more regular basis, not every single day. Then here I have this light that I bought from Primark again. It's, the reason I love it is not only because it's gray, but it has like a very raw cement kind of feel to it, which I loved. And I don't even know how this got here. I mean, my mom just put it in my room and I kept it. And then I have frames. This is my Masi and this is my Nani's sister. So that's that. And coming here now, this is basically a mirror that I got, I think, easily a year ago off of ASOS. I think I was in London and I got it shipped over there because I really wanted a small mirror with bulbs that would look nice in pictures. And we're lucky that it's working right now, because otherwise I'm not going to try switching it off. But usually when I try to switch it on, it never lights up. So until I find a replacement, this is going to be here. Coming to this now, I know that it might look like the products are kept here because it's all of the same color scheme and aesthetic. And yes, that was one of the reasons. But there are also products that I use not every single day, but quite often. Like this Aveda Dry Remedy is really nice for when your hair is feeling super dry. Then there is a simple eye cream. These little stones are actually part of the trip that I took with H&M to Arizona, and they all had a separate meaning. And of course, they went really well with this part of the room, so I kept them here. This tray is from Westside, and these coasters, I believe, are from Amazon, but they are really old. If I can find a link, basically, if I can find links to anything in the room, I will be leaving them in the description box. Over here, I have a candle that was sent to me by a brand called Sparkle and Wrap. And it's got my name on it. I haven't lit it yet, but it smells really nice. It's just that I mean, I'm tempted to light it, but also not. Like, you know, you don't want to get it ruined or anything. And it's on this coaster that is from a brand called Hermosa, which is, I think, Jaipur based. And they sent me two coasters and a couple of things on Diwali last year. So I kept one here and there's another one in that part of the room. This planter is again from Westside, and so are these flowers. I went and bought them yesterday while I was buying the other stuff for the room. But I love the color and it's got that very old rose vibe, which goes really well with the rest of my room. Talking about this chest of drawers, I've owned this for around 5 years. It was bought online from this brand called The Yellow Door Store. I just started searching on Google, basically looking out for a white chest of drawers, and that's when I found this. Originally, this had a white top and it was a slightly off-white cream kind of color, and these were black. But when we moved, we basically got a grey laminate put on the top so that it matched with the rest of the room. And I painted these gold by myself just so that it went with the rest of the room. But I think I'm going to be changing these because I'm not too happy with the way they're looking, especially with that dresser, since the drawers of that are grey. But I mean, that's okay right now. Now I'm going to show you my clock because I think it's really, really cute. It's again from Westside and I obviously picked it up because of the color. So whenever I wake up, because my bed is there, it's great because I can then see the clock directly. Coming to this part right here, there's like a little room over here. It's super tiny and it just has a wardrobe inside where I keep like my home clothes, my workout clothes, my skincare and hair care products. And then over there, I have my bathroom, which obviously I won't show you in today's video. But if you guys want to see that, we can do that another time. Coming to this section now. This is literally one of my favorite parts of the room. So basically, I saw this gold shelf on Pepperfry a couple of months ago, before we had moved actually. And they had it on sale. I will leave a link to it below. They have different sizes. And if you're looking for like something that has gold hardware, it's a really nice bookshelf unit kind of thing to add a little bit more to the room. So for the longest time, I didn't know where I wanted to keep it in the room, but I think it fits really well with this section. I have this vinyl player that I bought from Urban Outfitters in London. Basically, Urban Outfitters has a lot of these from Crossley, and I believe that they're also available on ASOS. But I love the color since, like I said, the color scheme of the room, this goes really well. This also is corduroy with gold hardware, so I couldn't resist. To be honest, the sound quality of this isn't amazing. I had read reviews online before I bought it, but I basically bought it for aesthetics. It does look really nice, and I have this, which is basically a stand that I got from Amazon. I'll leave a link to it. I believe it's from a brand called House of Quirk. And then I have all my different vinyls in here. This one is Spice Girls, which is not opened yet, because the only one that I always end up listening to is this Ed Sheeran one, which is the Divide album. He is my favorite. And then I have the High School Musical album, because I'm always going to be a Disney kid. I have this little teddy bear that is, I think it was given to me in November when the H&M Moschino collection launched. So that's here. Coming to this shelf, which is super, super exciting. This is my Cosmopolitan award that I spoke about in one of my previous videos, which I got 2 months ago, I think, for most engaging content. Then I have this random shell thing here that I picked up. It had a pearl in it, which I have lost. So until I find it, this is just going to be bare. I have my YouTube play button at the back for 100,000 subscribers. And then up here, I have these two awards that were part of the Palladium Spotlight Awards, which happened, I think it was around 2 years ago. So one was the People's Choice Award for Best Urban Style 2017, and then the Best Fashion Instagram Award. And then this last one over here is an award that I got a couple of months ago from The Upper Story, which is one of the top social influencers of 2018. So this is like my little award shelf, and it's just so special and it makes me so happy every time I look at it. Coming to these three baskets here, these are all again from Primark. There's a lot of stuff from Primark home over here because it's super affordable and looks so good. But I basically keep my palettes in here. This section is face palettes. I have one eyeshadow palette here, but the rest are all for the face. Then this section is more of eyeshadow palettes at the back. And then we have some more eyeshadow palettes here, I believe. Most of my makeup is usually stored on that side, but I wanted to be able to see my palettes because otherwise I forget that I have them and then I don't end up using them. So that's why they're here. Down there, I just have like a few trunks. I think I have a lot of brushes in these. And this is just like random skincare stuff, which I don't need to show you guys right now. Coming to this unit right here, I saw something very similar to this on Pinterest, where you basically had your TV unit extending into a desk. It was a really good idea because I wanted to fit a desk and a unit in this space, and I wanted to have like a good view, so it just worked for me. So we basically put the same grey laminate on the top that was on the chest of drawers over there. And over here I have my TV stuff with electric points and everything, which I've tried to hide with this little format. Not sure if it's doing a great job. But in this box right here I keep my lenses and lens solution and all of that since I need them every day. Over here, this is another basket from Primark that has a lot of books and stationery. And these two jars actually, since I end up traveling quite often and I can't always complete using the currency of that country, whenever I come back, I just put all the currency in this jar. So there's like a mix of everything in here, which will probably need to be sorted out at some point. And in this jar, I keep receipts that I might need to use for like return or exchange purposes. I'm not the most organized person, but I want to make sure that I keep my receipts in place. So this has actually been helping me quite a bit. This vase I picked up on my recent trip to London. I mean, I didn't pick it up. I ordered it online on ASOS again. And in their picture on the website, they had it on display with a really cool side table that was the exact same color. I really wanted to get that as well, but obviously I couldn't bring a side table back from there. So I just got this. I think these plants were given to me by some, it was part of some PR package if I'm not wrong, but I honestly can't remember. I just know that when I saw the vase and I saw this together, it just worked really well. I have a candle which is not lit right now, but it's one of my favorite scents from Bath & Body Works. It's so good. It's called Black Cherry Merlot. Another one that I really like is Mahogany Teakwood. That smells so good. Like, if you guys like musky fragrances, these are two candles you should definitely try out. I have two photo frames here. This one has my Nana and Nani, and it's like a really old picture of them. For me, I always keep telling everybody that my Nana was like the most good-looking man in the world. And this is one of me and my Nana. Coming here, this is another Primark basket, part of the same set that you have been seeing. And this has some of my hair tools. A lot of them are in like suitcases because I haven't unpacked yet. But these are some that I do use quite often. This color is what I used to curl my hair almost every single time. And then this Remington straightener has been with me for like 2 years and it's really good. Coming to this section, so this globe I actually spotted at the Oliver Bonas store in London when I was there in December. I was there on holiday for Christmas and I didn't know that it was also a light. So I saw it and I was like, oh, it looks okay. But it was on sale. I think they had around 40 or 50% off. But I didn't pick it up. And then I went back to the store and she told me that it's a light. And when she lit it, it looked so good that I had to get it. And I basically carried it in my hand the entire journey from there back because it wouldn't fit in any of my bags. But so worth it because it looks so cool. I mean, firstly, it goes really well with the room and I just think it looks really nice. Here I have my laptop. I actually want to get like a little stand or a mat or something to keep the laptop on. But for now, this is all we have. And I have a little notebook that I have been using recently. Coming to this chair, this was again part of the Pepperfry sale that I bought the dresser from. I basically ordered both of them together and I was looking for an office chair, like a desk chair that was gray or white for so long because every time you go online and you search for desk chairs, they're always like black or silver and they're really bulky and ugly. But I spotted this, I got it for, again, I think 40 or 50% off, which was so good. And I think I got the last piece because after that it was just showing sold out on the website. But if I do find it, I'll leave a link for you guys in the description box. Coming to the bed now. So basically this bed is my old bed but upgraded. So I've always had a single bed and I felt like it was not enough. So I used the same one. We just kind of extended the sides and created more storage under the bed. I keep all my coats and blankets and other stuff in there. So that happened, and then I got this headboard made as well. This is the first time I ever had a bed with a headboard, which is insane. When it came, I was so excited. I was like a little kid, and I've always wanted like a pink quilted headboard, you know, the kind that you see on Pinterest, and it's like all princessy. I'm a very girly girl sometimes. So yeah, that was that. We got the laminate of the bed also to match this strip over here around the wallpaper. I didn't tell you about the wallpaper. This, I basically wanted something to go with the color scheme of my room. Like I said, pink and gray was always something that I had in mind. But I also wanted like a little bit of a tropical feel. And when we saw this, we just got a catalog and I saw this. And I knew this had to be it for me. So we started off with the wallpaper, then we got the bed done, then we got these strips done because I wasn't being able to find the right gray paint for this wall to match the wallpaper. Hence we put the strip in the middle to add like a little bit of break in color, but it also kind of cheats the eye to believe that the color is the same. Coming to my bedside table now. So this is super fun because this table was originally, whatever you see, the gold hardware was all black. I ordered the table off of Amazon. I think the brand name was Khati or Khati or something like that. I'll leave a link to it below. They had four different colors and I bought what said was white on their website. But of course the laminate, my luck, it ended up matching the room really well. So the legs and this little thing were black, which I then painted gold. If you guys want, I can leave details of how I did it for you in an upcoming video or something, so that you can understand how I went about it. But I'll show you a picture of a before of the table and how it looked. essentially a proper transformation. And also the table was like super cheap. I think I got it for 2,500 or 3,000 bucks, which is insane. Coming to what's on the table now, there's this book that I've been reading recently, which has honestly made such a huge difference to my life. And I read a little bit every day. I still have a long way to go. But if you're looking for ways to be productive and change your mindset and just get a lot more done in your day, you should read The 5am Club. It's amazing. So this planter basically is something that I have got too many questions about on my Instagram and on the Snob Homes Instagram. So quickly telling you guys, the planter and the plant are both from Westside. This is a faux plant again. Like I said, that's what's happening all over the room. But I love the whole tropical vibe. And like I said, I wanted to have a lot of plants. Firstly, because I wanted green to kind of break the color monotony going on. And this just honestly adds so much more happiness when I wake up and I see that there are plants, even though they're not real. It just makes me a lot more happy and I feel a lot more motivated to do things and I feel so much more productive. Next up, I have this marble tray with like a little bit of a gold accent going on. And these are products that are basically part of my current nighttime skincare routine. Coming to this now, there's this super cute and tiny planter with a faux succulent. The succulent is from Amazon and the planter is from SheIn. Now, I honestly didn't know that SheIn did such good homeware stuff. It is a little bit tricky to try and find something that goes with your aesthetic because a lot of stuff that they have is like super childish, you could say. I don't know, like it's got a lot of bunnies and kittens and all that kind of stuff. But if you look and you search, you can actually find some really cute stuff like this and it's super affordable. A lot of you have also been DMing me recently to tell me that I should check out the homeware on SheIn. So I have checked it out and I do have a few things from there. Coming to this now, this is part of the same coaster set that I spoke about on that side of the room. And there's this candle on it that's rose gold and it's part of the Bath & Body Works White Barn collection. I think it's called Peppered Suede. Again, it's a little musky, it smells really nice, goes with the kind of fragrances that I like. Coming to these cushions now, this was sent to me by a brand and honestly, I don't think they knew that this was a color scheme of my house. I just happened to get really lucky because it went so well with my room. And it's called Rearrange Home, and if I can find a link to it, I'll leave a link to the product below. This furry white cushion is from Primark, and this is also Primark, I believe. Okay, there's no tag, but I'm pretty sure it's Primark. I bought it, I think, a few months back. And this bed sheet that you see right here is also from Primark. It's basically a duvet cover that's white on one side and pink on the other, and I think we'll go to that side now. So I forgot to talk about this lamp that was on that side as well, but I'll talk about it here. This actually feels like one of my best finds for the room. I bought this before we moved, before we knew we were moving here as well. This is from Primark again, and it honestly cost me just £7, which is around 650 rupees, which is insane. And the best part is that it's battery operated, so there's like no plug or anything that's required. And you can control how bright you want it to go. It's super cute and again goes so well with my room. Then I have this Marshall speaker over here. This was a gift when I moved and I just love it because I've always wanted a Marshall speaker, especially this color. Like I said, everything that's here goes so well with the aesthetic, hence I've kept it here. And I love listening to music like all the time before I go to bed, while I'm getting ready. So yeah, this is great. Coming to this, this again is from Primark, but I have seen something very similar on SheIn, so I'll leave a link to that for you guys. I just keep a few perfumes that I'm using currently. This one is from Erin and this is Jo Malone in English Pear and Freesia. And I have my most trusty Clinique Moisture Surge. Cannot do without it. On days when I feel like my skin is super dry, this is a complete savior. You know how much I love my Moisture Surge. Then here I have just my AC and TV remote control and my reading glasses. This is a little detox water situation going on. Ever since I felt sick, I have been trying to eat and drink healthy stuff and make a huge change in my diet and lifestyle, which I never used to follow before. So this bottle is basically with an infuser and it's specifically for infused waters. I'll leave a link to a similar one for you guys in the info box below if y'all want to check it out. Coming to this now, this is actually a super cute find that I got at Starbucks. I didn't even know that Starbucks would actually have something like this. And again, it went with the color scheme of my room. So this was part of their Valentine's Day collection and it's like a little bowl that I use for my jewelry. I'm currently wearing both my necklaces, but usually when I come back home, the first thing I do is remove them and put them in here so that they're just right next to my bed and I can wear them the next morning. When you open this drawer, basically all you see is medicines because apart from food, this is what I eat in a day. So currently there's a lot of medicines in my life and that's all that's here. Now coming to these two shelves, I basically just put a couple of random things. This wasn't planned. I didn't know what I wanted to put in these shelves for the longest time. So here is one picture of me and my mum from our trip that we took to Canada last year. And this actually is a super cute robot mini speaker. I bought this from Urban Outfitters 3 years ago and I have used it just once. The sound is not great, but it makes for a cute addition as home decor, so that's what I'm using it for. There's this candle that is again from Primark. It has a rose gold hardware and I just love it. It's like one of those jars that you open. I haven't lit it yet, but it's a really beautiful lily fragrance, so I think I'll light it soon. So these shelves are actually from Primark and there's a similar one over there which I completely forgot to show you, so we're gonna go back to that part of the room. So this shelf right here is actually from Urban Outfitters and I bought it when I was in Germany 2 months back or 3 months ago. And the gold was kind of not matching the gold of the other shelf over there, so I painted this one, like just the gold hardware. And then I got these two super cute planters, pink and grey, goes so well with the room and it was so exciting because they were super affordable on SheIn. And then I got four succulents which I bought from this store called Paradise in Lokhandwala. But I have seen similar ones on Amazon, so I'll link them for you guys below. So looks like my room tour is complete.
So that was my room tour. Oh my god, I can't believe that you guys have actually watched it and it's live. Okay. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you guys have been liking the fact that I'm really trying to be consistent on here. I have also been super consistent on my IGTV, so maybe you want to go check that out as well. This look that I created is also going up on my IGTV tomorrow, so you can follow me on Instagram, check it out, subscribe to my channel because there's a lot more home related stuff coming here and fashion related, beauty related stuff. So I'm really excited about where this channel is going and I hope that you guys are too. So don't forget to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it because it would really really mean a lot to me, and turn on your notifications so that every time I upload a video you will know. And yeah, I think I am done. There's nothing more to add. Links are in the info box below. And yeah, thank you so much for watching. I am so excited. I literally cannot contain my excitement, so I think I need to like calm down a little. Maybe I'll go meditate. But yeah, thank you for watching. I love you guys to bits.